Now this lecture is about calculation of moment of inertia of a uniform rigid rod. So it says calculate the moment of inertia of a uniform rigid rod of length L and mass m about an axis perpendicular to the rod and passing through its center of mass. So let us say we have this rigid rod and capital M is the mass of rod. And length of rod is L. Now this is the center of mass. So we have to calculate moment of inertia about an axis that is perpendicular to the rod and passing through the center of mass. So if rod is rotating about this axis, we have to calculate moment of inertia. So let us call this axis is OO dash. So we have to calculate moment of inertia about OO dash axis. If you remember, we have for moment of inertia, that is r square dm integral. So we can have I is equals to integral r square dm, where r is the perpendicular distance from the axis. Perpendicular distance from axis. And dm is the mass of elemental. So dm is the mass of elemental volume. So let us say we can consider a rigid rod, a small part of this rigid rod at a distance of x, and this length is dx. So we can use this formula r square dm. So I is equals to integral r is distance from axis, so this distance is x, so we will have x square. Now we have this distance is dx, we have to calculate mass of this elemental portion. So m is the mass of L length, so we will have m by L, that is mass per unit length. So this is mass per unit length. Because L length has m mass, so one unit length will have m by L. Now this elemental area has a length of dx, so we can multiply by this dx, so this term is dm. Now we can integrate, this is 0, so x here we have 0, and here we will have x is equals to L by 2, and this is x is equals to minus L by 2. So we can integrate x from minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So I is equals to x square m by L, we can take outside because this is constant, dx minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So we will have m by L x cube by 3, and integration is minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. We can take 3 outside, so we will have m by L, and this 3 will come here. Now one time we will have L by 2 q minus of minus L by 2 q. So minus minus will become plus, so we will have m by 3 L, and this is L q by 8, this is plus L q by 8. So in this case we will have m by 3 L into 2 L q by 8. So we will have this is ml square by 12. So moment of inertia of a rod passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the rod is ml square by 12. So moment of inertia about OO dash axis is ml square by 12. Now let us say if I have to find moment of inertia about one of the end. So let us say now rod is rotating about this axis, mass of rod is m and length of rod is l. So this time again we can consider elemental area at a distance of x. So this is elemental area and length of this elemental area is dx. So mass of this elemental area will be mass per unit length, that is m by l, into length of this elemental area, that is dx. So this is mass per unit length. Multiplied by length. Now we can use formula I is equals to r square dm integral. R is the distance from axis to the elemental area. So this axis is, this distance is x. So x square and dm is m by l into dx. Now I have to integrate x. Initially we have 0 and here we have x is equals to l. So we have to integrate from 0 to l. So this is 0 to l. We can take m by l outside because this is constant, x square dx. So we will have m by l x cube by 3, and this we have to integrate from 0 to l. So we will have ml m by l, and this is l cube by 3 minus 0. So this is ml square by 3. So moment of inertia of a rod about one of its end and perpendicular to the rod is ml square by 3. So moment of inertia of rod about one of its end and perpendicular to the rod is equals to ml square by 3. That is, if I have a rod, if rod is rotating about this axis, moment of inertia is ml square by 12. Now if the rod is rotating about this axis, about an end, this time moment of inertia is ml square by 3. Now this result we can also achieve by perpendicular axis theorem or parallel axis theorem, not perpendicular. So we can use parallel axis theorem. Now this theorem says moment of inertia about any axis, let us say AA dash, is equals to moment of inertia about center of mass plus mass of object times distance. For example, in this case, this is a case of rod. If we want to calculate moment of inertia about this axis, let us say this is AA dash and this is your moment of inertia about center of mass. So this axis is a axis passing through the center of mass. About this we know ICM, that is ml square by 12. Now this distance is L by 2. Now we can use this parallel axis theorem, IA dash is equals to ICM, that is ML square by 12 plus MD square. So in this case D is L by 2. So we will have ML square by 12 plus, now this M is capital M basically. So here we have M, that is mass of rod. Mass of rod is capital M. So this is ML square by 4. So we can take 12 LCM. So we will have ML square plus 3 ML square. That is 4 ML square by 12. That is ML square by 3. So these two results we have to remember, that is moment of inertia about an axis passing through center of mass, ML square by 12, and axis passing through end, this is ML square by 3. So this result you have to remember, and this is for uniform rigid rod. So rod is uniform, that is cross section everywhere we have same. So we have same cross section everywhere, and this is rigid, that is rod is not flexible, so it has a fixed shape.